Hi, Jeff Nelson here today. I'm going to give you some very specific things you can do in order to lower your risk of Alzheimer's disease. I'm going to first explain what these recommendations are based on and then give you the suggestions. In the past, I've made videos about omega-3 and dementia and batting down the idea that omega-3 supplements might prevent Alzheimer's. I've shown why vegans are being duped into buying expensive DHA supplements that aren't shown to do anything useful.
Nobody's been duped.
After one of my videos debunking DHA, I got an email from a newsletter subscriber. She wrote, "Please don't malign Dr. Clapper. I was on the Holistic Holiday at Sea cruise with him, Dr. Greger, and the amazing duo, the Dr. Sherzai. The brilliant neurologists were asked about DHA, and their response was that, although there is not hard evidence for a recommended daily intake, they both take algae oil and also give it to their remarkable children. That's good enough for me." Okay, let me first say that I don't believe I've maligned my friend, Dr. Clapper. I just disagreed with him on a study he cited to push DHA. He and I are longtime friends and business together for years, and he and I spoke on email just last week. As for the Sherzais, the neurologist couple who apparently say that while there's no hard evidence that supports taking DHA for brain health, but they take it anyway, I don't have any problem with that. I don't have a problem with someone carrying a rabbit's foot for good luck either. Although I kind of wish they wouldn't, but it's a free country. It's just that there's no empirical scientific evidence to support carrying a rabbit's foot or taking DHA for your brain. And I guess the Sherzais admit that, but they take it anyway, just, you know, just in case.
Just to be safe.
Now, just like everyone, I'm also concerned about Alzheimer's and dementia. I've seen it in my relatives. I don't want to get it.
Dementia.
I don't want anyone I know to get it. So what can you do to lower your risk?
Brain.
First, there's a large body of evidence that supports exercise to keep your brain healthy. Exercise can increase blood flow to the brain, enhance cognitive reserve, and it can reduce things like blood pressure, stroke, depression, things that are very much associated with higher risk of Alzheimer's. This is a picture of me with my son and his friend yesterday. We ran a half marathon, which is one of my strategies for warding off dementia. Obviously, eating a healthy diet with lots of fruits and veggies, high in fiber, low in junk and processed foods, that's important and can help as well. Cognitive stimulation like reading, writing, puzzles, playing an instrument, learning a foreign language.
I'm learning Spanish.
This is all healthy for your brain, as is staying socially active.
We're socializing, be social.
But now let's talk about the elephant in the room. And that is your exposure to aluminum. Now, Dr. John McDougall wrote an excellent article about Alzheimer's and aluminum, and I'm going to review some of the evidence he presents. I'll put a link in the description where you should go and read to learn more and also see the studies that I'm going to be talking about. But the first case of Alzheimer's was found at the start of the 20th century. It was reported by a German psychiatrist and neuropathologist, Alois Alzheimer, in 1901. Dr. Alzheimer documented the case of a 50-year-old woman named Auguste Deter, who presented with unusual symptoms like memory loss, paranoia, and psychological changes. After she died in 1906, he examined her brain and found abnormalities that are now recognized as key pathological features of Alzheimer's disease. He found the plaques and the tangles in the woman's brain tissue that pathologists see in Alzheimer's patients today. Today, there are close to 7 million people in the U.S. with Alzheimer's, and that number is expected to double by 2050.
That's a lot of people.
In addition to the tragedy of someone losing their brain function, Alzheimer's usually means you're going to have to spend an average of about $50,000 per patient year for someone who needs to be in a nursing home.
It's a nursing home.
Why the skyrocketing increase in Alzheimer's that we've been seeing in modern times? Well, quite a few studies point towards aluminum toxicity, which has been suspected as a cause of Alzheimer's for over a century.
Say aluminum.
Aluminum is the third most abundant element in the earth. Unfortunately, the most brain toxic metal that we commonly come in contact with.
Toxic.
And since the Industrial Revolution, we've refined aluminum into compounds like aluminum sulfate and aluminum citrate, which can be absorbed and concentrated in human tissue.
Contains aluminum oxide.
So for the past century, we've been living in the aluminum age, with most people exposed to unsafe amounts through food, water, and air. Now, why isn't aluminum toxicity a major public health topic today? Well, as is often the case with chronic disease epidemics, the truth faces opposition from big business.
Money talks, people.
As studies of aluminum's neurotoxicology emerged, the aluminum industry snapped into action. They hired researchers. They published articles trying to convince scientists, medical professionals, and the public that aluminum isn't the cause of Alzheimer's and to keep consuming their products.
You're blinding me with science.
What is is the research that threatens the aluminum industry? Well, two scientific reports are especially damning in their link between aluminum and Alzheimer's. The first, published in the prestigious journal Science in 1980, used powerful scanning electron microscopy and X-ray spectrometry to identify aluminum in these neurofibrillary tangles in the brains of Alzheimer's patients. Further research found aluminum poisoning directly linked to most of these scientific markers associated with Alzheimer's. The second significant report was published in March of 2017. This research established a direct human connection between the amount of aluminum accumulation in the brain and the severity of Alzheimer's. It showed that those who developed Alzheimer's in their late 60s or older accumulate more aluminum in their brain tissue than individuals of the same age without the disease. The timeline of evidence is highly compelling, starting with the discovery of aluminum's toxicity to the brain and nervous system in 1897. In 1901, as I say, the first case was reported by Dr. Alzheimer. In 1911, Dr. Alzheimer described in The Lancet the characteristic neurofibrillary tangles seen under his microscope in his patient's brain. 1911, William Guy's expressed concerns about the use of aluminum in baking powders based on 7 years of research on the effects of aluminum salts in animals and humans. 1926, only 33 cases of Alzheimer's had been reported. 1965, a mechanism for aluminum causing Alzheimer's disease was shown by injecting animals, in this case rabbits, with aluminum and producing the neurofibrillary lesions, the classic pathological microscopic finding of Alzheimer's. 1973, brains of patients with Alzheimer's were reported to have 2 to 3 times more aluminum than people of comparable age without dementia. 1980, scanning electron microscopy and X-ray spectrometry found the lesions and tangles contained in a central core of aluminum. 1983, a report was published that patients on chronic hemodialysis treatment for renal failure receiving high concentrations of aluminum developed dialysis encephalopathy, with concentrations of aluminum in their body as much as 12 times normal. 1986, a higher aluminum content of drinking water was correlated with an increased incidence of death from dementia worldwide. 18 studies have found this association. Aluminum is added by the water utility to increase the clarity of the water. Now think about this. The DHA pushers struggle to find one study that shows a tenuous correlation between omega-3 levels and Alzheimer's, and they can't really find anything that strong as a correlation, but 18 studies show an association between aluminum intake and Alzheimer's, and every time they repeat them, they get the same association. 1991, treatment with desferoxamine, we'll call it DFO, a chelating agent with a high affinity for aluminum, was found to reduce the amount of aluminum in the brain and body tissues and to slow the progression of Alzheimer's in patients. They injected the DFO intramuscular, that is into the thigh or into the buttocks, for 5 days twice a day. It dramatically slowed Alzheimer's decline in the group that was treated with the DFO. 2015, more than 24 million cases of Alzheimer's reported worldwide. 2017, aluminum concentrations in the brains were reported to be directly correlated with the severity of Alzheimer's in patients. To me, that fairly recent study is like a smoking gun of what's causing this epidemic. So if aluminum exposure is a significant factor in Alzheimer's, what can we do about it? Well, avoid it.
Stay away from it.
Don't eat it. Don't breathe it. Don't expose your skin to it. Common sources of aluminum include drinking water, coffee beverages made using aluminum mochas, aluminum containers, foils, cans, aluminum cookware and utensils, food additives, infant formulas, medications, personal hygiene products, and vaccinations. In addition to avoiding aluminum, there are ways to enhance the removal of it from your body. And as I just mentioned, the study, the chelating agent DFO, has been reported to remove this toxic metal from body tissues and slow Alzheimer's progression. That has to be administered by a doctor. Current research also promotes the consumption of silicon-rich waters as a means to enhance your aluminum removal from your body. In a study where patients drank about 34 ounces of silicon-rich mineral water each day for 12 weeks, aluminum removal was increased and clinical improvement was seen in some of the Alzheimer's patients. Aluminum is not a nutrient. There's no reason for it to be in your body. It's pretty clear that avoiding aluminum exposure is a crucial defense against Alzheimer's.
Get rid of it.
Get rid of it.
Get rid of it.
Get rid of it.
So throw out your aluminum pots and pans, avoid foods prepared with aluminum additives, steer clear of aluminum-containing hygiene products like some deodorants, and don't accept any medications or shots that may contain aluminum. The FDA mentions aluminum as being added on this page titled Adjuvants and Vaccines. It talks about forms of aluminum that are injected via vaccine, and further down on the page here, it lists some specific shots that have aluminum in them. As well, some versions of the flu vaccine may contain aluminum. So you may want to seek out one that doesn't use aluminum if you take vaccines. Now, the FDA acknowledges problems with aluminum. On this page called How to Treat Diarrhea in Infants and Young Children, it says, products to relieve diarrhea, such as Pepto-Bismol and Kaopectate, contain bismuth, magnesium, or aluminum, which can be harmful to infants and toddlers because they can quickly accumulate in young children's bodies, but not in the bodies of older people? There are even a lot of reports claiming aluminum is being sprayed in the sky from airplanes as part of cloud seeding or weather control. I hope that's not true because it could do a lot of harm. Remember, here there's no magic bullet, there's no pill or supplement that's going to protect you from Alzheimer's. You do it by improving your diet and your lifestyle and by cutting exposure to aluminum. It's up to you 100% what you want to put in your body. Nobody can force you. I don't take nutrition advice from the government. I don't take health or medication advice from them either, but go my own way completely, and I suggest you do the same.
Documentation of high-level government corruption.
To read Dr. McDougall's full article and to see links to the studies discussed, click on the link in the description. That's it for today. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share it, and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Until the next time, stay informed and stay healthy.
Phenomenally corrupt government.